In these strange times, I welcome all of you to this funeral mass, those present, those who are joining us via the streaming, and those who are with us in spirit. It's a strange time, as I mentioned, when we're on the usual customs and traditions we have at funerals, we're not always able to be fully observed. But there is one thing that remains constant. And that is God's love for us, God's love for all of us. And that's what we celebrate in the Mass today for Robert. God's love for him that brought him the forgiveness of his sins. God's love for him that blessed him with grace in this life. God's love for him that welcomes him into eternal life in heaven. That is our prayer today. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Robert to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let's now be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth. For the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him because we shall see him as he really is. The word of the Lord. Please stand to greet the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "See that you're dressed for action and have your lamps lit. Be like men waiting for their master to return from the wedding feast, ready to open the door as soon as he comes and knocks. Happy those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. I tell you solemnly, he'll put on an apron, sit them down at table, and wait on them. Maybe in the second watch he comes, or in the third, but happy those servants if he finds them ready. You may be quite sure of this, that if the householder had known at what hour the burglar would come, he would not have let anyone break through the wall of his house. You too must stand ready, because the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Please be seated. I'd like to begin this morning by offering my sympathy to those who are grieving and mourning for Robert, to his extended family circle, his neighbours and friends, to his in-laws, to his grandchildren and great-grandchildren, to his own children, Robert, Bridget, Anne, Mary, Bernadette, John, Stephen and Margaret. To each of you, I offer sympathy on the death of your father, someone who was very important in your life and probably still remains such, someone who gave you much of his life and helped you as much as he could in the journey of your life. To all of you today, as it children, we offer our sympathy. And it is his wife Annie that we remember most today. They're married for 60 plus years, a long time to share your life with anyone. They shared a loving life together, a good life together, and a life that was full of grace and love. To her today, we offer her sympathy and our great loss. Robert was one of eight from his own family. His brothers and sisters all predeceased him, and his parents too. And so we pray and include them in our Mass, the funeral Mass for Robert, that they will be together again in the kingdom of heaven. Robert enjoyed a good story and believed he had the knack of telling a good yarn. He enjoyed a good film, or as he referred to it himself, a good picture, such as The Quiet Man, with one of the heroes being John Wayne. But he had a wide taste in pictures and enjoyed them well. I'm told he loved a good bargain and enjoyed nothing better than a bit of good barter. And he believed strongly in never paying the full price for anything. He was proud of being a Belfast man, hailing from Holy Cross in Ardoyne, where he began his journey of faith and life. Robert was good company and had a good sense of humour. Today we celebrate a good story of his life, centred on a decent man who loved God and did his best to live according to the gospel of Christ. He put his trust in God, believed in his love and forgiveness. Robert hoped that God would welcome him into eternal life with him in heaven. And that's what we pray during this Mass, that God will forgive him his sins and God will reward him for his goodness and his faithfulness in this life and bring him into eternal life with him in heaven. The gospel is a powerful story with a beautiful ending, and Robert recognized it as a good bargain not to be missed. The promise of baptism being fulfilled, hence he always remained faithful to God and the practice of his faith, coming to Mass here on a Sunday in St. Comgall's with his wife, praying to God, trusting in God. The gospel reminds us that there will be a hospitable welcome to all who trust in God. It's not hard to imagine the stories that Robert and his brothers and sisters will tell to one another and to God when God is serving them at table in heaven. Today is a time for all of us, an opportunity for all of us to consider our story and what it is that we believe in, what we live by, and where we think it will lead us to. Who will be our hero? What will be the end of our story? And will we enjoy a happy ending? Things we all need to think about and consider in our journey of life. For Robert, we are confident that it is a happy ending of his life on earth. Sad for those who loved him that he is gone, but good for him in his end of his sickness and suffering. And even happier beginning to eternal life in heaven. That is our prayer for this Mass for Robert today, that as he completes his journey on this earth, he will begin a new journey with God in heaven. I'd ask you now to stand for the prayer of the faithful. God, Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. And I invite Rachel to come forward to read the prayers.
For Robert, a husband, father, and grandfather, who deeply enriched the lives of his family, we gather here today in remembrance of his life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all the NHS staff who cared for Grandad in his final days and hours, Their struggles and sacrifices then and in the trying times ahead must be acknowledged and never be forgotten. May they have the reward of their bravery and goodness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That God may welcome into his glory Grandad and the others of our family and friends who have departed this life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That all of us here who are grieving the loss of their husband, their father, or their grandfather may be consoled and strengthened at this time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. For a moment, we pray quietly to God for our own concerns and worries. Lord, hear us. God, our loving Father, we make these prayers in faith through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Let us stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Robert may be taken up into glory with your Son, whose great mystery of love we are all united. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. When this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us now kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so they may come for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Noel our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Robert, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us now stand. For at the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Let us now kneel or be seated. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For the distribution of Holy Communion today, I will go to you in your seats. If you wish to receive communion, I'd ask you to stand. If you don't wish to receive communion, remain seated. And I'd remind you that communion can only be received in the hand during this time of epidemic. Let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternally grant rest unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Robert may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Just before the prayers of commendation, once again on behalf of the people and priests of the parish, to offer our sympathy to all of you and to his wife Annie especially on the death of Robert. And so we pray the prayers of commendation. Trusting in God, we've prayed together for Robert and have come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Robert again and enjoy his friendship. Though this family will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joys of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. In that faith, we sprinkle his remains with holy water to remind us of the promise of resurrection he received at baptism. We incense his remains to remind us of the sacredness of the body, a temple of the Holy Spirit. As we do these two things, let us pray in silence for the happy repose of the soul of Robert. A response: receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Robert, in the sure and certain hope together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Robert in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant. Help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. To all meet in Christ, we are with you and our brother forever and ever. Amen. My friends, in peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.